Hello and welcome to this new video. So this video is under the sign of darkness today because the Bitcoin has lost 10% and is now in the 5,500, 5,600 US dollars. So it's pretty depressing. Everybody's pretty down. The dream of having a Lamborghini for Christmas are now totally buried. It was still possible to consider this as a realistic perspective in December 2017. And then the more time goes, then the more people just have more realistic expectation, and no, cryptocurrency will not make a billionaire anytime soon. So in these pretty gloomy days, I wanted to give you a bit of hope. What is hope? Hope is often a very bad advisor that will make you take silly decisions. At the same time, hope is what make people still breathe when they lack oxygen, because they are hoping that somebody is going to save them. Hope is the feeling or the perspective that people during the war consider, and this hope is called peace. So hope is not so bad. It's just very bad when you use it to stick to a position and just to get buried forever. So let's have a look at this chart. This chart looks a bit like bubbly, with what we can call here a double top. And we go from, let's say, the five something here to 80. So it's a multiplication by 40. Then we have a down, then where's the, okay, we have a down, we have a up, and then the last bullish hopes are gone forever, and we are back to 10. So it's a divide of the stock price, because it's a stock, by 10. What happened to this stock afterwards? Because when you consider this picture, you're just going to think that the downside is very, very huge. What about the upside? Was this stock dead forever? Was it just gyrating around the 10 or the teens? Well, not so much. That's Amazon. So of course, Amazon is well known because it's quite exceptional progress. Because of Amazon, even the financial analysts have to invent a new valuation models, not taking into account PER, you know, price earning ratios, because PER is quite stratospheric, reaching 300 at the climax around the 2000. No, Amazon is using the concept of free cash flow. And when you use the concept of free cash flow, that I'm not going to detail here, Amazon is has been for a long time undervalued. So that's here, the red arrow, the last days of the bear market, which led after to a fantastic bull run. And let's consider now this run a bit closer. So here you see, this is the great crash. What looked so appalling, so dramatic, so tragic in the long-term perspective is very, very tiny. It was just an artifact, just a tremulation like a heartbeat over entire life. So the great crash has been dwarfed by the remarkable behavior of Amazon, and it's been remarkable because Amazon is remarkable. Amazon has been defying everything you can think about, including because before you had just a curse, because every time you had a company doing great, the company couldn't help trying to expand into some new territories. I have in mind a firm called Vivendi, who was initially doing water supply, public water supply, and which in the end purchased Universal. And so that was totally nonsense because it was funded by debt, notably. And it was nonsense because it was done at different time, and there was not, let's say, the synergies that you can now have and that Amazon has with its remarkable panel of clients and also its computing power. So I'm not a total specialist of Amazon, but what I want to show is that if you have a great or an exceptional asset, whatever the down move can be in the early days, then it's pretty much negligible. Now, you will say, maybe Bitcoin is right now here, or at the top was here, and maybe this is 2011. Yeah, maybe it's totally possible. But as I told you, today is building great hope. So, great crash versus all-time high, plus 3,000%, which makes it multiplied by 31. So, yeah, also you see the Amazon behavior. So it's quite interesting to see that first you have the Nasdaq 100 joining, then SP 500, SP 100, and it's not done yet, but who knows, maybe Dow Jones someday. That's where we stand, and now I probably would have needed some hope as well, because I was a very, very strong believer of a coin called Publica. Publica was, let's say, my love story with cryptocurrency, because I invested pretty much at the ICO, which is around here, and I sold somewhere around here. So I was quite lucky, and I really believed in the business model. Publica is a decentralized self-editing platform based on Ethereum blockchain. So it means that you don't have the usual parasites that eat on your back. You don't pay 70 or 80% of the book price. In that case, it was just 10%, and there was let's say authorized protection, because once you have a token, you cannot duplicate it. If you want to make a copy, you have to print screen it. It's quite complicated. So Publica was basically the coin of my life. And what happened to Publica? Well, of course, I sold too early. Then I saw that we were on the downtrend. I was quite a firm believer of the model. However, despite buying, I just realized that nothing was really happening. And now I have to consider that this investment is pretty much finished. So I sold almost all of my tokens, taking quite a big hit, because between the highest portfolio I had and now, Publica has decreased by 80%. Still, I don't want to capitalize on hope, because there's no hope, I think, anymore. The only hope would be a self-created hope, but would be based on no real fact or observable behavior. So I sold. You can see the spike in volumes. I'm part of it here, but it's a weekly view. So then I just sold for one Bitcoin something. And I say bye to Publica. It was a nice story. Now I have to concentrate on winners. I'm still in Phantom. I'm considering to use the current purge to buy, but let's say very little by little, some coins. And for those who would ask, where do we stand with Bitcoin? It's not the total catastrophe. You have to again take into account the long picture. We come from here. It was, yeah, pretty much 1 year ago. So we are back 1 year ago. We are still in a big correction criteria, And despite being very, very impressive, the move here is quite small. Of course, symbolically, and I want to talk about that, symbolically, it's very significant because it's breaking this very famous ocean of no volatility that was enabling to anticipate upwards. So this is the biggest bullshit I've ever, ever heard in my life. There's no rule saying that when you have a contraction in volatility, it means that you're going to have an upside. No, if you have a contraction in volatility, it means that you will have some move, not upside. And as there was, you know, it's the quite a classical consensus, but considering that everybody was very optimistic, that the short position was very, very low, how do you want Bitcoin to go up with everybody so bullish? So I have really no idea of where the Bitcoin is going. Really no idea. I started, let's say, on what I think is a buy zone here. A buy zone to start, not a full in buy zone. I started accumulating here. So just talking about a couple of thousand USD. Accumulating here some Bitcoin because we are in a quite friendly zone, I would say. And also, what is important to consider is that everybody pretty much had the stop loss on the same level. And this move is totally coordinated to suppress the price. So the price suppression can go very, 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 very low. But still, I started doing the purchase here. I'm into this time a long-term perspective for many reasons I could detail later or in another video. But I want to start accumulating for the long run some Bitcoin, and so I initiated today this position. I was out most of the year. I didn't try to take some trades. I took some trades more on altcoins. I keep some altcoins that I have, including Phantom, which is not doing so bad given the context. And we'll see after where we are stopping. And for the next purchase, I will more wait of confirmation of the downtrend stopped before accumulating again. All right, so hope you enjoyed this video, that my accent is not too terrible. And don't lose hope. No, it's don't lose faith. If you really believe in Bitcoin as I do, Bitcoin not as much as a means of payment but as an investment vehicle. Okay, we know it's based on nothing, but Bitcoin has many intrinsic characteristics that I can detail later, which make it quite valuable, I think, in comparison to currencies, to fiat currencies. All right, so thank you very much for watching. Don't hesitate to make some comments so that I can improve the video, because it's my second video in English. And bye bye.